What's up, guys? So finally, this is the part 2 of my Japan trip 2020. In this video, I'll be sharing you the rest of my trip in Japan. For those of you who haven't watched the part 1 of my Japan trip, you can check the video link in the description below. So, let's just sit back and enjoy watching the video. Since nandito pa din ako sa Osaka, sinulit kong puntahin ang Osaka Castle.
Naako diri karon sa Osaka niya. Ang cherry blossom wala pa na munga. So, kanang nadira mo na siya ang Osaka Castle.
Osaka Castle is one of Japan's most famous landmarks and it played a major role in the unification of Japan during the 16th century of the Azuchi Momoyama period. It's quite a long story, but for our information, the Azuchi Momoyama period is the final phase of the civil war or conflict in Japan back in the 16th century.
Nakapodiri ka ron sa Kyoto.
Ngayon guys, nandito na tayo sa Kyoto. Around 10 to 12 minutes walk from the JR station before reaching to Arashiyama Bamboo Grove. Hindi ka din maboard kasi merong mga souvenir shops, food shops, and dessert shops na madadaanan mo lang.
Can I have a... the mix?
Huh? Wow!
Hey guys, what's up? Na ako diri karon sa as you can see sa background, na ako diri sa Arashiyama forest. So kaning lugar diri duol ni siya sa sa station sa Kyoto ni siya, part ni siya sa Kyoto. So daghan diri mga turista karon bisag na ay virus. So magwear na tag mask.
The Arashiyama Bamboo Forest is one of the most visited tourist attractions here in Kyoto, Japan. This is also showcased in the movie Memoirs of a Geisha.
Muna siya gitawa o bamboo forest diri sa Kyoto. So sikat ni siya nga forest kay ang mga bamboo diri is natural nga pagtubo nila. So wala siya gi plant sa human kundi natural siya ni tubo diri kaninga lugar. So muna siya isa sa tourist attraction diri sa Kyoto.
Pagkatapos kong mag-bamboo forest, pumunta ako dun sa Kimono forest naman, which is a few distance lang sa Arashiyama Bamboo Grove. Ang Kimono forest is a man-made siya and consists of gorgeous cylinder-shaped pillars. Maganda siya pag medyo gabi na or late ng hapon. Sa Kyoto pa din tayo guys, but this time I went to visit the Fushimi Inari Shrine. Ito din ang isa sa mga most visited tourist attraction here in Kyoto. Since this is the last day of my tour in Japan, I decided to rent a kimono para masulit ko din ang experience ko dito. I just keep them satisfied through the weekend. Do like 9 to 5, I'm the weekend. There are a lot of kimono shop rentals in most of the tourist attractions in Japan. But for the rental shop that I rented my kimono, which is near the Fushimi Inari Shrine, it cost around 4,500 yen. The shrine sits at the base of a mountain, also named Inari, which is 233 meters or 764 feet above sea level.
Hey guys, what's up? Nagyapon ko diri sa Kyoto. Sa shrine, muna siya ang famous tourist attraction niya. Nag-rent ko og kimono. So far, tungas mig bukid.
The Fushimi Inari Shrine includes trails up the mountain to many smaller shrines which span 4 kilometers and take approximately 2 hours to walk up. Fushimi Inari is the head shrine of the Kami Inari. Kami Inari means the spirit of general prosperity and success.
Nahuman na ko ground ang Inari Shrine. Mingaw kay diri. Murag mabungol ka kay wagyoy ka ng sound ng mga hangin or something.
Like the Arashiyama Bamboo Grove, Fushimi Inari Shrine also showcased the movie Memoirs of a Geisha.
After all, these are not the memoirs of an empress.
So guys, this will be the end of my Japan 2020 trip. I hope you all enjoy, especially dun sa mga nanunood ng part 1 video ko and up to here sa part 2 video. So thank you so much guys for watching. And then sana din sa susunod na trip ko sa Japan, kasama ko na yung family ko. Hopefully the COVID-19 will be over soon. So thank you guys for watching.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel.